My name is Rebecca Sorber. I work in Udo Rudloff's lab in the National Cancer Institute. So we're working on pancreatic cancer, which is one of the most deadly cancers out there. It's not the most common cancer out there, but it is one of the deadliest. So when people get it, it's only 5% of people are alive at 5 years after they get that diagnosis, and a lot of people don't live past 6 months. So I'm from Indiana originally, and went to school there, have been there pretty much my whole life. My parents are not scientists. My parents don't have a science background. My dad works in a factory, and my mom was a stay-at-home mom. I always liked science because we didn't have cable, and so I watched a lot of PBS. And so I watched a lot of like Nova and all those shows like that. And so it was something I was interested in. And when I went to school and started taking classes like chemistry and physics, I found out I was good at it. And so started thinking about majoring in something scientific in my undergraduate career. So I went to Purdue University and majored in biochemistry. Right off the bat, got involved in research and kind of got really interested in that and had several internships. And then with that research background was thinking, okay, how do I want research to fit into my medical career? And so I decided to take a year out and got in this program at the NIH. Okay. It's definitely a collaborative process. I just came over here from another building where I was doing some microscope work with we call it the confocal cord, just a fancy word for a microscope that can see pretty colors. We have collaborators in Alabama. We have a student that just came to our lab from Alabama. We also have collaborators on the West Coast in California who actually developed the peptides. So there's a lot of interplay between government-funded research and then the private sector, and just it's impossible to do research alone these days. So yeah, it's a collaborative effort.
Checking the concentration of protein, and we use a standard.
So it's great because you can start so small. You can just start with something really, a really small project that can be a part of a bigger effort. Like, we're all working on making this peptide and this drug into something that will hopefully help people with pancreatic cancer, but we all play a very small part in it. And somebody who's, say, 14 years old could come in and be a part of that. And it's being part of something bigger and really getting your hands dirty. Is like you're using your hands, but you're using your brain too. So I think that appeals to, it's just you're able to become a part of something very quickly, I think, and something that has very important implications. But this is satisfying on a different level, so it's kind of a delayed gratification, whereas you go into the clinic, you talk to somebody, change around their meds, help them right away, and you feel, oh, I did something good today. You don't always get that feeling in the lab, but it's kind of a delayed gratification and moving towards something bigger. But research is really the only way that you can help a massive ton of people instead of just one person at a time. So I think that's what appeals to me about it. I think if there was a high school kid seeing this video of me talking about this, they're already further along than I was in high school, because I wasn't even thinking about getting into research and things like that. When I was in high school, I didn't really know it was out there, just because I didn't have anybody in my family who did that. So just reach out to people. Everybody in the research community, and for the most part in the medical community, they're really excited if somebody who is young and in the high school age is interested in getting into their field. So I think just reach out and always stay curious and keep learning. That's what I would say.